areas of overflow. In life, it's either you rule or you are ruled over. Either you dominate or you are dominated. Either you are in charge or you are discharged. He said, wherever the sole of your feet treads upon. Before you got there, there were people there. But as you are landing, I'm discharging them so that you can take charge. So what are these 12 areas God wants us to overflow in? Number one is in the area of the anointing. It takes the anointing of God to break yokes. When you lose the anointing, you remain bound. Thank God for certificates. But how far can certificates certify your life without grace? Isaiah chapter 10 verse 27. It shall come to pass in that day that his burden shall be lifted off your shoulder and his yoke be broken off your neck, and the yoke shall be destroyed because of the anointing. The more anointed you are, the more yokes you destroy. As long as you have not contacted that anointing, the family may still be bound. But where the anointing is available, satanic powers are broken, demonic yokes are destroyed. Where the anointing is available, the anointings are terminated. The second area of overflow is in the area of love and kindness. Overflowing love. Proverbs chapter 10 and verse 12. This is not the era where you carry malice and carry bitterness and carry unforgiveness. It is the era to release yourself. It's the era to free yourself. It's the era for liberation. If you live everywhere because somebody offended you, then you may end up only in your kitchen. And may God help you that you don't have a chicken or a dog because they also offend you.
As you have forgiven people, that is how God will raise people to forgive you. As you show people love, that is how God will raise people to show you love. As you show people kindness, that is how God will raise people to show you kindness. Beloved, it is better for 100 people to love you than 10 people hating you at the same time. He said, love covers multitude of sin. That means there will be sin, there will be offenses, there will be grievances. But he said, forgive. Malice robs you of your joy. As you release others, God will release you.
Number three area is the area of overflowing health.
The Lord said, wherever the soul of your feet shall tread upon, is given to you for a possession. You shall possess sound health in the name of Jesus.
Number four, the fourth area of overflow in 2020 is overflowing wealth and investments. I don't care how dry the land is, your account will never be dry. Your business will never suffer setback.
2 Corinthians chapter 9 and verse 8. And God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that ye always having all sufficiency in all things may abound
unto every good work.
Wealth shall look for you. The last time you were broke shall be the last forever. The last time you were poor shall be the last forever. The last time your account was zero shall be the last forever. Whether you like it or not, it doesn't matter what the system is saying. There shall be overflowing wealth.
Number five, overflowing the area of relationship and families. When the devil wants to deal with you, he sends the wrong people into your life. When God wants to deal with the devil, he sends the right people into your life. Nothing commands unstoppable and overflowing upliftment like having the right people around you. There are people that will believe in you enough to invest into your life. There are people that believe in you enough to speak on your behalf in the boardroom. There are people that believe in you enough to defend you. There are people that believe in you enough to sacrifice for you. God is bringing them your way. The journey of life and destiny will be delayed when the right people are not in your life. The journey of life and destiny will be accelerated when the right people step into your life.